Hi, my name's David Moss. I'm the CTO and co-founder of Blue Prism Limited. And today I want to talk about robotic automation and how Blue Prism empowers the business user to automate their own processes. So if we put Blue Prism in context, where do we play? Where do we fit within the enterprise? What we like to talk about is conceptually the long tail of change. And what that means is within any modern enterprise, there are a range of processes varying from highly complex, significant in terms of business value, all the way down to very general, low value processes, which nonetheless have a large number of currently manual users performing them. These kinds of processes at the moment are being manned by the business, and effectively they're using people to deliver these processes. What Blue Prism is saying is, why can't we put in place a technology platform that's governed by IT and configured by the business that enables you to push out the benefits of technology further along that long tail and to automate those business processes using a technology platform? And that's what Blue Prism's about. So how does it work? Well, Blue Prism extends your existing applications, your presentation layer, and allows the business to use the same systems that you've given to all of your users with the same validation, the same security, the same rules and the same data. But instead of using a person to operate that system, Blue Prism allows you to create an automated process, a robot effectively, to work the systems in the same way that your users would. So once you've trained Blue Prism in the same way that you train a user, you can then put that process, that virtual user, onto an application server in a data center and run those processes at scale. And because you're using your existing systems, there's no new data, there's no new security concerns or access. You're just layering on what a user can already do. You're creating a Blue Prism robot that layers on top of that and automates that process. So let's take a look at Blue Prism and see what steps we go through to model your applications to then design a procedure and run it on your virtual workforce. This is the designer, the front end to the database where we have all of these objects and processes. The first thing we're going to do is to have a look at a business object and see how we model your applications and create these reusable actions. So if I go into Object Studio now, what I'm going to do is open the object for our proposal system. Each one of these tabs that you can see across the top is an action that our user would have taken in that application. And we're now training Blue Prism in how to do it. So the first step that we need to go through is the modeling. We need to tell Blue Prism all about the system that we're going to be working with and tell Blue Prism about specific aspects that we want to reuse. So the first thing I'm going to do is launch the proposal system and then have a look at the proposal page here. Let's imagine we want to use customer number in one of our automations. The first thing we're going to do in Blue Prism is just to create a container for that customer number field and then tell Blue Prism all about that element. So we're going to attach to the browser and take a look at customer number. When I click on that particular field, Blue Prism is then going to use the definition of customer number to interact with that part of the screen when we talk to it in future. And then once we just create some links in the flow, what we can very quickly do is run Blue Prism against the application that we've got side by side with the software, so we can highlight the current stage, and when we step again, we can see that Blue Prism successfully connected to that part of the system and entered the customer number we asked it to. We can also do things like read the fields out of Blue Prism, we can navigate around the different applications, we can wait for different events. Anything a user would have done in the system, we can build a process around that. So once we've created our business object and it works, we can then publish it. And that makes it available to the processes to use in Process Studio. What you'll see here is a very similar interface. The difference being that each one of these boxes you can see is an action that we've already created in Object Studio. So we're effectively packaging up what a user would have done and then redeploying that into lots of different procedures. We're using that training to create lots of processes. And here you can see all the different actions, some decisions being made, and these rules that were in the spreadsheet that were saying we can check the eligibility of the customer, these are now embedded in Blue Prism, and so we then get the control within here. Once you've tested your process, again, you can then publish that, and it becomes available to run in your virtual data center, in your virtual workforce. So if we go into control room, what you can see here on the left-hand side is a list of all our processes that we've written and tested and published. On the right-hand side are all of our virtual workers. These are our virtual machines in the data center that are ready to run Blue Prism processes. So running a process is as simple as dragging the process onto the virtual machine or using the scheduler if you want to run it at a certain time each day, and then running that scheduled process. So when I start this selection, what it's going to do is get my process out of the database, and then for that process, it's going to go through the different steps that I've designed. So what you can see here is it's logging onto our billing system, where it's going to locate the customers that we've talked about. It's going to log onto the proposal system, where it's going to create the new accounts if the customer fulfills the criteria. And then what you'll see in the background is it's going through each account who's asked for this product. It's making decisions based on that customer's data, and then it's doing the proposal, or it's rejecting that customer and writing back to them, depending on the outcome of those decisions. And so Blue Prism is effectively doing the work of your manual users, but doing it in a virtualized data center based offering. Once that's executed, within our centralized Blue Prism database, we have a complete audit trail of all of the actions that Blue Prism took and the reasons for those actions. So the decisions that we made, why we made those decisions, and what impact that had on the account. It's very useful for audit purposes, but it's also really useful for MI. We can use this information to feed back into the process and iteratively improve the way the process works, increasing the hit rate that we get in terms of the number of accounts that Blue Prism processes. So what you've seen is that because we've taken this object-oriented approach to wrapping your existing applications, you can very quickly deploy Blue Prism very widely across a large number of processes. What's more, because we use virtualization and infrastructure which is common to a large number of organizations, it's very easy to scale Blue Prism. Let's say you need extra resource because of a regulatory requirement or a product launch. You can very easily assemble more infrastructure to work Blue Prism processes, and the only install you need is your standard desktop plus the blueprism.net framework, and then you're ready to go. So very easy to scale, very quick to scale, and very resilient and robust once you've got it up and running within that data center environment. So hopefully that's given you a good flavor of the Blue Prism approach. There's plenty more information on the website, and thank you for watching.